Hello everyone, welcome to Ortho Implants for Life. This week we will learn about proximal tibia locking plates fixation procedure for proximal tibia fracture. So let's begin.
We will start with proximal tibia locking plate lateral 4.5 system. First, we will use a K wire to hold the plate in the fracture site. The K wire stays in, and then we will first fix a non-locking screw in this plate. In order to do that, we will use a drill guide 4.5 mm. We will place that in the non-locking hole of the plate. Hold it there and then drill through the non-locking hole with a 3.2 mm drill bit. After drilling, we will take the measurement with the help of a depth gauge. Once the length is measured, we will take a 4.5 mm cortical screw of the measured length and then with the help of a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver, we will insert the cortical screw in the non-locking hole and fix it. After fixing the cortical screw, we will have to remove the K wire which is holding the plate so that it does not get bent. Next, we will fix the proximal part of the plate, for which we will fix a 4.9 mm locking sleeve in the locking hole in the proximal part of the plate. After fixing the locking sleeve, we will have to drill. We will take a 4.3 mm drill bit and drill through the locking sleeve. For few companies, there is a scale already printed in the drill bit with which you can take the measurement of the length of the screw required. If it is not there, we will first remove the 4.9 mm locking sleeve and then take the measurement with the help of the depth gauge. There are two type of locking screws used to fix this plate. One is a 4.9 mm locking canceller screw and 4.9 mm locking cortical screw. Canceller screws are used to fix the canceller part of the bone. As a proximal part of tibia is cancellous, that's why we will fix the proximal end of the plate with the help of a locking canceller screw. After taking the measurement, we will take a 4.9 mm locking canceller screw of the measured length and with the help of a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver, we will lock the screw with the plate and the bone. Now the shaft region of the tibia is basically cortical, so that's why you use cortical screws in the shaft region. In order to fix a locking cortical screw in the shaft region, we will again use a 4.9 mm locking sleeve and fix it in the locking hole of this plate in the shaft. Then again, we will drill through the locking sleeve with the help of a 4.3 mm drill bit. Once the drilling is done, we will use the same procedure. Either we can take the measurement if there is marking on the drill bit, or we can use a depth gauge in order to take the measurement of the length of the screw required to be fixed. Thereafter, we will take a 4.9 mm locking cortical screw of the measured length and then use a 4.5 mm solid screwdriver and lock it with the plate and the bone. The process of fixing the locking plates for proximal tibia fracture is almost the same for each and every plate. We have shown you a 4.5 mm system. Now we will show you the procedure for a 3.5 mm system. In this case, we are taking a proximal tibia locking plate medial 3.5 system in consideration. So to start with, we will hold the plate in the fracture site with the help of a K wire. Then we will use a 3.5 mm drill guide in order to drill through the non-locking hole. And then take a 2.5 mm drill bit and drill through the non-locking hole through the drill guide. Depending upon the manufacturing company, this drill bit can be of 2.5 mm or 2.7 mm, which is used to drill through the non-locking hole for 3.5 systems. Once we are done drilling, we will remove the drill guide. After that, a surgeon may or may not use a 3.5 mm bone tap for a 3.5 mm system to clear the entry of the screw. This step is totally a surgeon's call. After that, we take the measurement with the help of the depth gauge. Then we take a 3.5 mm cortical screw of the measured length and then with the help of a 3.5 mm solid screwdriver, we fix a screw in the non-locking hole. After this procedure, we will remove the K-wire. As I said, we do not want it to bend during the compression. Thereafter, we will fix a proximal end of the plate and we will use a 3.5 mm locking sleeve and fix it in the locking hole of the proximal part of the plate. Then we will use a 2.8 mm drill bit and drill through the locking sleeve. Then we remove the locking sleeve after drilling and take a depth gauge and take the measurement of the length of the screw required to be fixed. Then we will take a 3.5 mm locking canceller screw. And with the help of a 3.5 mm solid screwdriver, we lock the screw in the bone and the plate. As explained, the proximal end of the TBI is a cancellous part. That's why we fix a locking canceller screw. After this, we will fix the shaft end of the plate with the locking screw. And for this, we will again take a 3.5 mm locking sleeve and then take a 2.8 mm drill bit and drill through it. Then use a depth gauge to take the measurement. Then we take a 3.5 mm locking cortical screw of the measured length and with the help of a 3.5 mm solid screwdriver, we lock the screw in the plate and the bone. Once this is done, in order to do a final check with the locking screws, we will use a 3.5 mm torque limiting screwdriver in case of a 3.5 mm system and a 4.5 mm torque limiting screwdriver in case of a 4.5 mm system. And then we will keep tightening the locking screw until it makes a click sound. Thereafter, we will not tighten it any further. The click sound means it is completely locked. Now, at times, surgeons prefer to use the screwdrivers with a power drill rather than using it freehand. So, in such scenarios, it can be done with the help of a quick coupling or QC screwdriver, 3.5 mm QC screwdriver and 4.5 mm QC screwdriver. For 3.5 mm and 4.5 mm system respectively. These screwdrivers can be fixed in a power drill and can be used to tighten the screw. That's all for today.
If you've enjoyed the video, like it, share it. If you're new to our channel, subscribe it. Hit the bell icon to get the notifications for our upcoming videos. If you have any queries, comment below and we will surely reply back. If you want to know more about career prospects in orthopedic implant industry and wish to start a career in orthopedic implant industry, please click the link below in the description box and DM us to know more. Thank you and see you in our next video.